is Richard Baxter, and I'm a board-certified pediatric dentist and diplomat of the American Board of Laser Surgery. We've used LightScalpel for, I guess, 4 years now. We've really enjoyed it. It's been such a helpful tool in our office. We started out with a diode laser, so for about 18 months, we first started doing procedures, phrenectomy procedures specifically, we use a diode laser, and I can tell a huge upgrade with the LightScalpel. Looking at the different options, the LightScalpel seem to have the best combination, the best bang for your buck, so to speak. So it has, obviously, for soft tissue procedures, I think the CO2 wavelength is the best. So then it comes down to Soleil or the LightScalpel, and I guess there's a Deca too that's kind of older and they're kind of revamping now. But for the LightScalpel, the flexible waveguide makes a huge difference. So it's much easier to use. I've demoed some of the other ones, the articulated arm, and it does seem kind of clunky. But also the size of the unit, so when we have to move it between rooms, it's really easy. I think it's 40-ish pounds versus some of the others are 100, 150, 200 pounds to move. So smaller footprint, and then just easy controls. I don't have to worry about it. The settings stay put, and you can have the presets. Compared to the diode laser we had before, the diode laser you had to pay for the disposable tips every time, around $7 a piece. So it's almost like a toner and printer issue where you can get the cheaper printer, but then you pay for it in the toner versus with the LightScalpel, it actually turned out to be more economical and it paid for itself in the first month.